here are the some situations in which external pressure occur relative to chemical engineering. We will discuss these situations and a type of vessel. The first one is a vacuum vessel. This type of vessel is purely designed for low internal pressure. The typical example is triple effect evaporator. The vacuum in this type of vessel may be created with the help of vacuum pump or steam ejectors. Second type is external ejector vessel for heating cooling purpose. In this type of vessel, hot fluid or steam or cold fluid flow outside the shell in the jacket, which may exert a greater pressure than the internal pressure of the contents. So this type of vessel, we can also say them the external pressure vessels. A typical example are the batch type reactor, crystal, vacuum crystallizer, and so on. The third type of the vessels are vessel inside condensing steam or gas. In this type of vessel, gas or steam condensed inside the vessel. This results in low internal pressure and greater external pressure. This situation often occurs in the gas cleaning or steam cleaning of vessels. For the design of the external pressure vessel, these are the most affecting parameters. The first one is the thickness of shell T. Second one is the diameter of shell D, and the third one is the length of shell L, and the fourth one is the strength of material of construction E. These four parameters have more effects on the design of vacuum vessel. So we have to relate these terms to see a combined effect. In step 1, we will assume a thickness T. Any value of T can be assumed, say 5, 10, 15 or 20 mm in the start. And in the next step, we will calculate dimension L and D. Here L is the design length and D is the inside diameter. Dimension L should include 1/3 the depth of the heads. This is very important for all the vessel of various types of heads. So we will start with the calculation of design length L. Here we have a vessel with the hemispherical head, and its related equation for the design length is L is equal to LTT plus 0.33 into D. Here LTT is the tangent to tangent length of the proposed vessel and D is the inside diameter. And here we have a vessel with D 0.8 meter and LTT 1.6 meter. And we will calculate the design length L with the help of these dimensions. Here we have a vessel with tangent to tangent length is 1.6 meter and inside diameter is 0.8 meter. And we will calculate design length of this vessel. We have to calculate the design length of this vessel. We will plug the values of LTT, that is 1.6, and inside diameter, that is 0.8. As a result, we will get a design length of 1.86 meter for this vessel. Now we will discuss vessel with ellipsoidal head. In case of vessel with ellipsoidal head, the design length L is equal to LTT plus 0.166D. By inserting the values of LTT and D, we will get the design length L is equal to 1.321 meter and new length is 1.321 meter with same corresponding diameter. The next is vessel with toward a spherical head, and for this case the design length can be calculated by the following equation, and L is equal to LTT plus 0.112D. By inserting the preceding values as in preceding case of LTT and D, we will get the design length for this type of vessel is 1.28 meter with the same corresponding diameter of 0.61. The next step 3, and we will calculate L by D naught and D naught by T ratios. First of all, we will assume a thickness T that is 10 mm. Any value can be assumed in the start, and then we will calculate T naught, that is ID plus 2T. Here 2T is the thickness from both sides of the cylinders, and that is 0.79 meter, and L by D naught is 2.25, and D naught by T is 79. We need these values to find out factor A and B in the next steps of calculation. In step 4, we will determine the factor A from ASME code section 11 part D and sub part 3, also known as a geometric chart for components under external or compressive loadings. To determine the factor A, we need L by D naught and D naught by T ratios, as we have previously calculated these values for vessel with hemispherical heads. So we can get the value of A, that is 0.0081, and in the step 5 we will calculate the value of B. To calculate the value of B, we need three things, that is the material of construction of vessel and the operating temperature of vessel and the factor A. Assume the material of construction of vessel is SS and operating temperature is 300°F. By using these data, we can find the value of B, that is 11,800. In step 6, we will see that if the value of factor A fall to the left of the material line and we cannot find out the value of B, then we can utilize directly this relationship to find out the allowable pressure. And in step 7, we will see that if the value of A fall on the material line, then we will find out the value of B. And we will plug the value in the following relationship, and this relationship is only applicable when the value of D naught by T is equal to or greater than 10. So by inserting all the values in our example, we can get the allowable pressure, that is 199 psi, which is much greater than the design pressure of vessel. So we will assume we will reassume the thickness of the vessel and reevaluate the calculation. And in step 8, we will evaluate the calculated allowable pressure. If the allowable pressure is greater than the design pressure, then reduce the thickness and repeat the steps of calculation until and unless we get a reasonable value of allowable pressure, considering all other factors such as occlusion allowance, safety factors. And if the allowable pressure is less than the design pressure, then there are two options: either select a new thickness and proceed from the beginning, and this option B can be selected to utilize the stiffening ring to reduce the L dimension. If the stiffening ring are to be utilized, then proceed with the following step. As we have seen in the previous example, that the allowable pressure is much greater than the design external pressure. If we construct a vessel with such a value, it would be overcast and over designed. So we have to rethink, and we will reduce the thickness and again start from the step 3, and assuming a new thickness, that is 5 mm, we will calculate D naught, that is 0.78 meter, and then L by D naught, that is 2.28. And then D naught by T, that is 156. Using these values, we will find factor A and B in the same way as earlier. Calculating allowable pressure again for 5 mm thickness. Now we will repeat step 4 and we will find factor A using geometric chart for L by D naught and D naught by T, that is 0.0028. And in the next step, B is determined using operational temperature, material construction of vessel, and value of A, that is 4250. Step 6 is not applicable in our case as is falling on the material line, not to the left. So in step 7, we will insert the values, and that is the allowable pressure is 36 psi. We can see that this value is quite satisfying. If we also add the corrosion allowance and safety design margin, and considering other factors, this value is quite satisfying. And also vacuum vessels are more prone to failure as compared to pressure vessel. So all considerations should be carefully taken into account while designing the final thickness of the vessel carefully